Stability Ice Strikes Back and with Stable Diffusion 3.5, we now have the next generation of high-quality image generation models. But similar to Flux, the checkpoints are extremely large and not very well suited for low VRAM GPUs. However, with GGUF, a well-known format for quantized models that reduces file size significantly, we can now access much smaller SD3.5 files, including one model that's currently under 5 GB. And because GGUF uses less VRAM, it also runs faster. On my GPU, the performance has nearly doubled. I expect more GGUF models to come, probably even smaller. More on that later. By the way, if you want to know how to use GGUF with Flux, watch this video. Also, if you need to install ComfyUI or Flux on Comfy, I've covered those two in another video. In this video, you will learn how to install GGUF for Stable Diffusion 3.5, both the large and the large turbo models. You'll also learn how to integrate GGUF into your Comfy workflows, and I'll provide free access to my example workflows. Finally, we'll do a quick quality comparison of several GGUF quantized models with the original F16 models and the scaled F8 model. Now here comes the fun part, we start with the installation. As usual, all links are in the description. We require the ComfyUI manager. If you haven't installed it yet, check the linked video. These are my ComfyUI and manager versions. If you have older versions, you have to update your Comfy. In the custom notes manager, search for GGUF. This is the extension we require. For ST3.5, you need a version not older than this one. Otherwise, you have to update. For GGUF with ComfyUI, we find all information on City96's GitHub page. At the bottom, there are the links to the related GGUF models on Hugging Face. This is for the large model. Go to Files and Versions. There you can find models with different quantizations. As a rule of thumb, the bigger the file, the better the quality. And Q-something-1 files are better but slower than the O files. In case QKS or QKM models are uploaded, these are even better and slower. Nevertheless, you should use the largest model which performs well with your VRAM. I have 16 GB and usually choose the Q8O model. Don't worry if you have less VRAM, even the Q41 model still performs quite well. All quantized models you can see on this webpage have in common that they are much smaller than the original F16 file. And even the scaled F8 version is much larger than the GGUF Q8O model. So download some of the GGUF files and put them in your models unit folder. We do the same with the large turbo model. I created an extra directory called SD3.5 in my models unit folder and stored the files there. From Stability AI's Hugging Face page under Files and Version, we require the VAE file. Put it in models VAE and rename it to Remore Speaking Name including SD3.5. In case you already have the original SD3.5 model files, but no VAE, you can do the following small trick. Create a new workflow in Comfy, add a new load checkpoint node where you select the SD3.5 checkpoint, add a VAE save node and connect both nodes. By default, the output path of the VAE save can be found in the output folder of your Comfy. Once you queue this short workflow, there you can find the saved VAE file. On the ComfyUI examples webpage, we find links to three text encoder models. You have to download all three and put them in models clip. If you have already worked with Flux, you know ClipI and T5. ClipG is new. I suggest to additionally download the FP8 scaled T5 encoder, which is smaller and a good alternative to the FP16 version. By the way, in contrast to the older Stable Diffusion checkpoints, even the original ST3.5 checkpoints do not include any text encoders. So you would have to download them even when not using GDUF.
But what about the quality? Is there a big difference compared to the original F16 models? And which quantized model should you use? By the way, if you want to see more videos like this, press the subscribe button.
Let's have a look at the first workflow. We start with large. You can download all workflows from my Patreon for free. The link is in the description. In the load model group, I have added a load checkpoint node. You can alternatively connect it to the other nodes in case you don't want to use GDUF. By holding and pressing the keys Ctrl M, you can activate and deactivate the node. In the GDUF unit loader, you select your model file. On my PC, I'm using the large Q8O version. In the triple clip loader, all three text encoders are selected. On my PC, I'm using the bigger T5 FP16, but the T5 FP8 is a good option too. The load VAE node, well, it points to the ST3.5 VAE file. I've prepared a prompt in the text encode node. As you can see, ST3.5 is capable of using natural language. Although you can use negative prompts with ST3.5, using them can result in bad results, that's why I've set it to 0. If you want to use negative prompts anyhow, create an additional clip text encode node and connect it like this. The conditioning 0 out is not required in this case, means you could deactivate or delete it. In the latent image node, you select the resolution of the generated image. I'm using the SD3 version because internally it uses more channels than the non-SD3 version. In SD3 you have the option to change the model sampling. The default is 3.0 and you can see some examples later in the video. And here we have the normal K-sampler node. Suggested steps are 20, but I found 30 or even 40 can sometimes be an improvement. For CFG you may start with 1.5, but I found best values are from 2 to 4 or even 5. Several samplers and schedulers have already been suggested in my opinion. Euler with SGM uniform is a very solid choice. Let's generate. No, I don't think Flux is dead, but I like the style of this image. Generation time on my PC with AMD is only a bit more than half of Flux, which is for sure an advantage. The image was cherry-picked from some dozens. In order to find the best parameters, I massively used XY plots on Comfy. If you want to try them yourself, check the linked video in the description. Regarding quality, the Q8O model is extremely similar to the original FP16. That's what we've already experienced with GDUF for Flux. FP8 is also close and Q4O is a bit different, but not bad. In the second example, FP16 and Q8O are same again, but FP8 differs a bit. Q4O has less details, but is still okay. For comparison, here is same prompt with FluxSchnell, cherry picked from 10 images. Dev has its usual very small depth of field. Why did I generate images with dragons and not people? I actually generated a lot of images with the prompt of this thumbnail for GDUF for Flux. Well, the results didn't impress me. It was particularly difficult to obtain images with good hands and correct text. Turbo wasn't as bad as feared, so we'll continue with this model. The workflow is more or less same as that for large. Of course, you have to select a GDUF turbo model. The parameters are a bit different. Suggested are 4 steps, but I found 6 to 8 steps or even 10 are better. Important. The CFG has to be much lower than for large.
values between 1.0 and 1.5 are a good starting point. Sampler and scheduler stay same. The generation time per step corresponds to that of large and is therefore significantly faster overall. The result looks a bit more artificial in this image, but not bad. FP16 and Q8O are again almost the same. I haven't found an FP8 model. Q51 surpasses Q40 in the details. While making this video, the medium version of SD3.5 was released, so let's take a look at that too. Unless there was no medium model available on City96's GitHub page today, but I found some from ND911 on Hugging Face. The link is in the description. The smallest model has below 2 GB. Download what fits to your GPU. On my PC I will use the Q8O model again. Well, the workflow is nearly identical. For the following cherry-picked generation, I'm using 20 steps and the CFG of 3.0. Sampler and scheduler, well, you know. Just make sure to select the correct medium SD3.5 Q model. And if you're low on VRAM, select the FP8 version of the T5 clip text encoder. The result is a little special but has its own style. In this case, the best results are again achieved with F16 and the comparable Q8O. The medium model surprised me with another prompt. People seem to be generated better than dragons. If you would like to use other GGF models, City96's GitHub page is a good place to start. In the discussions section, there is even a topic on how to generate GGF from safe tensors yourself. And in a second topic, there is a list of additional models in GGF format. The list is still small and mainly contains flux models, but has good potential to grow in the future. Currently, GGF is only available for the base SD3.5 models. The most exciting development will be the release of customized SD3.5 large models, hopefully with GGF versions. This could finally provide a true alternative to flux, even for generating images of people. So will you try SD3.5 or are you sticking with flux? Let me know in the comments, and if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like.